welcome at my funeral, or maybe your funeral. Who has thought about his funeral yet? A little bit? Yeah, funeral, yeah. And what do you think about, if you're thinking about funerals, what do you think? A little coffin, nice flowery bouquet, three songs, 45 minutes in a real cold funeral home? I don't think so. We need to do new things in funeral. New things in saying goodbye to people. So I did some research the last 3 years, researching about funeral experiences. And now I'm training funeral organizations and funeral entrepreneurs and doing nice new marketing things and preparing them for the future. As you can see, it's a whole other thing than the three songs, 45 minutes, and maybe a glass of wine. So the classic funeral is gone, babies. It's gone. Gone. We don't want three songs. We don't want 45 minutes. We don't want coffee. We don't want cake. We want whole other things than the classic funeral. So what I did was researching the future of funerals. And this is what it's going to look like a little bit. It's going to be transition events, and everybody's going to say, transition events? Yes, transition events. We're going to transition from a wet world, like your body, into a virtual world. You can't understand what I'm saying, but it's really going on. This was sent to me this week. A guy from Amsterdam made a holographic pocket device, which you can use to make movies while you're still alive. And when you die, your relatives can play yourself off. So they can constantly get you out of the pocket and say, yeah, mom, I don't know what to do. Very easy. Virtual transition. But the most important thing I'm going to say is not just a virtual transition and still the 45 minutes, the three songs, maybe a glass of wine. No, we're going further than that, because this is going on in Holland. Yeah! Woo! Bring in the Dutch, babies! This is Holland. We got some nice tiger coffin, nice tiger funeral car, and don't you like the missus? Helemaal in the styling. So this is going to be the wet dream of every fashion designer. We do the funeral thing, but we also do the wedding thing. But the funeral thing is more important than the wedding thing, because weddings are going to crash eventually. And we're all going to die. Okay, so my statement in the funeral business, I did some research, like 3 years. I was talking to all the funeral organizations, say, yeah, what's the future of funerals? They say, yeah, nothing's going to change. Of course, nothing's going to change. Everything is about money, 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 money. They got some 10,000 coffins they want to sell you. They got the flowery bouquet, it's like 10 years the same, so they want to sell it to you. But there are lots of other opportunities. I'm going to give you some Dutch examples of the new ways of funeral, and you must think about your funeral if you want this or not. You can still confirm to the 45 minutes, the three songs, and maybe a glass of wine. But I think that's not enough for all the lives you live in. So this is a new thing. This is an ash collector box. If you die, you go shoved in the oven, and then you can pick an urn. Urine, I had to say before, but it wasn't good. So now I'm telling you, it's an ash collector. So this is an ash collector. It's made of waste plastic. So not only things being in fashion like textile and that kind of stuff, but also things are entering the funeral scene, which are being in fashion. This is waste plastic, and they make a really nice ash collectors of it. I'm just waiting for the one that's really big, where I can lay down like a fetus and then you just push me into the sea and then, I'll be in heaven. So new things in Holland, it's just Holland, 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 bring in the Dutch. Bring in the Dutch, but also the Swedish one. Yes. Those big dominating brands entering the funeral scene, yeah. So I was thinking this is circulating for on the internet for almost 6 or 7, maybe 8 years, and it's really in the art scene, you know? Only the art people know what we're heading to. So this is circulating on the internet. It becomes in like 6, 7 versions. So I asked in the research, I asked to the funeral owners and the funeral companies, what do you think if this is happening? And they were scratching their head. Because it's about money. And if IKEA just entering the funeral scene, yeah, we don't want to collect our things at the classic funeral homes. So IKEA could be providing us a new do-it-yourself coffins. So if we got IKEA, we also do the Prosecco. This was launched this week. Oh yeah, Prosecco car. Everybody say, yeah, I want it for my wedding. I want it for my wedding. I want, oh, if I have a birthday, I want it. Yeah, if you die, you want this too. You're gonna want this too, of course. You want to drink, you want to do drugs, maybe something like that, but you surely don't want to do the 3 songs, 45 minutes, maybe a glass of wine. Yeah, if you got a glass of wine, you can do this. So in the future of funerals, we will be having funeral food trucks, funeral influencers, funeral meal teams. So if you're lying on the ground, you can't say nothing because somebody has died. They give you, yes, you have your food at least. You have some food in the house. So if we have Prosecco, we also do Heineken. Heineken, really big brand, of course. Heineken could provide funeral cafes. It seems kind of crazy, but we need it because people are going for alternative locations. We don't want the funeral home. We don't want the 45 minutes. We don't want the 3 songs. We don't want a glass of wine. No, we want beer. So in the future, there will be funeral cafes local, hosted by local brands, but also by the big brands. Because at a certain point, people are going to want alternative locations. But you can imagine if somebody's having a cafe and they're getting like 30 coffins a week, they don't want to do it. So there's going to be some specialist entering the funeral scene saying, yeah, I've got this really nice grief relief cafe where you can cry or shout or maybe do other things. I don't care. This is going to be the funeral of the future. Next generation funerals. Because the next generation really wants big experiences and they want thrilling locations and they don't want 2 glasses of wine. No. They want the full barrel of wine. So, funerals are going to be those in transition events. And my statement is that there are going to be a lot of new brands entering the funeral game, and it's not the brands that we don't know, it's just the brands we know. The technology brands, the fashion brands, lifestyle brands, travel brands, food brands, anyone could enter the funeral game. So if you got all the experience, maybe with the barrels of wine, and you're going to have a DJ, maybe a nice party, and you're saying farewell, after that you're going to need silence, silence. So, in the future, there will be technology and lifestyle brands hosting some silence things. Because in the future, urban living will be rare. Silence will be rare. You don't find silence on every corner. It's going to be like police cars every day, crying, kill your kids, etc. So, in the big urban jungle, we're going to need silence. So, big companies are going to provide us in silence. Think about rituals providing us silence gardens. Maybe silent cells, silent hotels, who knows? And if you got the silence, and you got maybe the experience, the branded funeral experience with all your friends, then you want to go travel. You want to get out of the system, get out of this. So you're going to travel, yeah. Now you're going to do that by yourself, individually. But in the near future, tour operators and also airlines will provide you in grief relief traveling. You can dump the ashes maybe at the Himalaya or just gradually let them go in some wind somewhere. But maybe not alone, maybe in a whole group. So you can go travel and do retreats with all kind of yoga stuff and everything, but they're going to provide you. So my case, in future funerals, is the thing you saw just with the performances. But we're also going to have big company brands entering the game, just like all life experiences are adopted by big brands. So I was watching a documentary and I said, hey, Ghana knows it's the place to be, funerals. So if Ghana knows, why don't we know it? So we're still confirming, at least at the Netherlands, we're still confirming to the three songs. 45 minutes, maybe two glasses of wine, or a cake, coffee, you can do that. So I want you to think about if you're dying just like now, this coming minute. So you're saying, yeah, I didn't think about the funeral. No, but you have to, because maybe you're gonna die. You're gonna hear. Drop downstairs and break your neck, you're gonna die. So when I went to this TED Talk, I almost died because I almost had two accidents within 3 minutes. So I almost died. And so, oh yeah, I have to have, what do you want in your funeral? Yeah, I don't want to lay in a coffin. I want to be in that shell I just let you see. So I want you to think about the future of funeral, of course, because it's going to be a big experience thing. It's going to be a branded experience. It's going to be a future funeral branded experience. And that sounds really scary, but not as scary as it is today with the 45 minutes, and three songs, and maybe a glass of wine. So think about your funeral, people. I do, at least, because I don't want people to bury me like I was like some flat girl laying in a coffin with 45 minutes. I don't want that. So my message to you is think about the funeral and think about the things that are happening in this scene now. You can do a lot of things more than just the coffin and the flowery bouquet and people grieving on you. So do that, people. Bring in the Dutch, I would say. Think about your funeral, because you're only going to die once.